Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll be going over the vocabulary and grammar for the song We Can by Kishidan and Hiroshi Kitadani. It was featured in the anime One Piece from episodes 747 through 806. It was released on August 24, 2016, and it reached number 31 on the Oricon Weekly Charts, stayed there for 3 weeks, and sold over 5,000 copies. So here is how format's going to be. Up on the top, I have the furigana, which means I have the kanji here. And on top, I have hiragana up here, a phonetic guide of how you would say this kanji, like it said sekai. And then below that, I have the romaji, which is this just in English characters. And then the English translation itself. And below, all the definitions for each and every word up here, which we will go through starting now. So we have この世界の hatte nante konomede mita wake janai. And that is kono means this. And then sekai is the world, so kono sekai is this world. And then no is making that describe hate, which is the end or the limit. And it's not the end of the world like the apocalypse, it's the end of the world like all the way to the end and back, like the whole world through, like you've seen it all. And then nante here is like such as, or just adding emphasis to what was said before, this end of the world. And then kono is this. And me is like your eyeball, so this eye. Then de is showing the means of, so by or through these eyes. Mita is the past form of miru, which is to see. And it's an ichidan verb, so to make it to its past form. That ru changes to ta, so miru becomes mita, so like was seen, so seen with these eyes. Then wake janai means like it doesn't mean that, or that's not the case. So it's not the case that these eyes have seen the whole world, so I haven't seen everything yet. And the next verse we have, dakara tabidatsunda kimi to we can. So dakara is so or therefore, and then tabidatsu is to begin a trip or just to depart or embark. Then nda is the explanatory no and it's casual n here. And da is the declarative, so we're just saying like the fact is, or the matter is, we're gonna start on a journey because we haven't seen everything yet, so we're gonna depart. And then kimi is you, and to is with, so with you, we can. And then this is just English, that's why it's in katakana here. As you'll notice, these characters are a little bit different than the other ones. They're maybe a little bit more blocky, because they're actually a different alphabet that's used primarily for loan words, like when they're saying English words in Japanese, like here, because we have this we can. So therefore, we're starting a journey, and with you, we can do it, so we can do it together. It's really sweet. Then the next verse we have, umi kara umi o mata ni kakete hitotsunagi no takara sagashi ni. So umi means beach or sea, and this is the same one. So kara is from, so this is from sea to sea. And then o is making that the direct object marker. Next we have our hata ni kakete, which is the te form of hata ni kakeru, which is to travel all over. So you're traveling all over from sea to sea. And to make that te form, this is an ichidan ru verb. So the ru just becomes te. So mata ni kakeru becomes our mata ni kakete. And that's like and or leading off. We're traveling from sea to sea and we're doing this as well, which is our hitotsunagi no takara. And this is specific for the manga, because One Piece in the manga, if it's written out in Japanese characters, it would be is this, which is Hitotsunagi no Ohihyo. And as you can see, like that's pretty much the same here, this Ohihyo. It's pretty much the same takara we have here. It just doesn't have all these honorifics making it more bigger, because this is dai, which literally means larger. This is more like big treasure versus this is just treasure. So well, they change it up a little bit in the song, maybe to get it to fit. But this essentially means One Piece, which is the treasure that they're looking for in One Piece. And there's been some conjecture in the fan community about what this actually means, because hito can mean a person. Hitotsu can also mean like one, so it could be one nagi. But also tsunagu here, tsunagi is the ma stem of tsunagu, which is to tie or to connect. So it's like maybe it's the treasure that connects people. Maybe there's some extra meaning in there. But we still don't know what the treasure is, and hopefully they'll eventually find it. Maybe it'll connect everyone together, you know? We'll see. But for now, we just gotta search for it with our sagashi here, which is the ma stem of sagasu, which is to search. And to make that ma stem, this godan su, the u-based ending, changes to its e-based ending, so su becomes shi. So sagasu becomes sagashi, and that makes it into a noun. So this is more like the noun, the thing of searching for the one piece. And then ni is designated that as our direction or goal. So we're going to search for the one piece. Kind of like while we're searching from sea to sea. It's our ultimate goal. But our next slide here is... Sona no yume monogatari datto darimo ga waratte iru kedo. So sona is such, and that's something that's about the listener or ideas expressed or understood by the listener, so you. And then no is linking that to yume monogatari. You might have heard something like this before if you've ever seen the Bake Monogatari anime. And it's like the very similar thing going on here. This monogatari just means story, and in front of it we're putting on yume, which means dream. So this is like a dream story or like a fantasy. And the bake monogatari, bake means like ghost or monster. So a bake monogatari is a ghost story. So you can kind of use it in different ways like that. This is just really like a fantasy or a fantastic story. So such a fantastic story, like what we're talking about before, like searching for the one piece. Datto, if that's the case, if that's what we're talking about. Daremo, anyone or everyone. And ga makes them the subject. The waratteiru, which is the teiru form of warau, which is to laugh or to sneer or to ridicule. So that is a godan u ending verb. So to first make that to its te form, that u changes to a little tsu to te. So warau becomes waratte. Then you just put on iru at the end. For warau, waratte. Waratteiru, which is kind of you're going to or you're in that state, like the gerunding form, so you're laughing. So like if that was the case, if you're doing such a fantastic story, anyone would just laugh. They wouldn't take it seriously. Kedo, but our next verse we have mune no takaburi dake ga dashinban shita kaburi shiteru yo. So mune is your chest or your heart or your feelings. And then no is making that describe takaburi, which is the ma stem of takaburu, which is to be proud or to get excited or to get worked up. This is kind of like our worked up feeling. And then this is making it into a noun. So that du ending, it's a godan nu ending. So it's u-based ending, changes to its e-based ending for this ma stem. So takaburu becomes our takaburi. And then dake is only, so like only the excitement in our chest. And ga makes that the subject of the sentence. Then nashinban is a compass. Shita is the past form of suru, which means to do. And suru is an irregular verb, so you just have to memorize that it becomes shita in its past form. It's a little lame, but there's only a few irregular verbs. Most verbs follow the rules. But just not suru, it's a rule breaker. So it's like our hearts will be our compass. That will be what we use as a compass. And then kaburi. Here is the ma stem of kaburu, which is to bear or to take blame or to assume responsibility. And then this is again the same ma stem. That du here is again changing over to its e-based ending. So that u, that du, is becoming a ri. So kaburu becomes our kaburi. And then that is actually going to link it up to shiteru, which is another suru. It's suru in its te iru plus imperative form. So suru in its te form is shite. And then shiteiru, you just put the iru at that. So shiteiru would mean you're doing something. You're in the process of doing whatever you're doing. And then to make that imperative, which means it's a command form, and this is a brusque, kind of rude way to ask someone to do something. So that do, that u-based ending changes to its o-based ending, so do becomes it o. So suru becomes shiteiru, becomes our shiteiro. So this is being commanded to do something. You're being commanded to like assume responsibility, to take up the burden. And then yo is the exclamation right here. So we'll take up that burden and just use our feelings, our worked up feelings, our excited feelings as our compass. We'll figure it out. Next we have 教科書なんてさ、ガイドブック。 So we had this 教科書 means textbook. And nante is things like, so textbook-like things. Or it can also just be adding emphasis to textbooks, like underlining that. And then sa is a bit manly. It's adding assertion. It's like, hey, we're gonna do that. And then this guidebook is English for guidebook. Again, that's why we have these katakana going on here, because it's a loan word. It's not Japanese. So stuff like textbooks, they're just guidebooks. Don't take them too seriously. Find your own way. Yeah. And our next verse and our last verse for this video, oh no, is Ame mo namida mo itsuko wa yamu kao o agero ikari o agero. A nice big one to end on. We've got this Ame is rain. Can we see like little raindrops in it? Anyway, and then this mo, this is a special mo. When you have noun mo, noun mo, it means both nouns equally. So this is both rain and tears equally. Namida means tears. And then itsuka is sometime or someday. And wa makes that the topic of the sentence. And then yamu is to cease or to stop. So someday, both your tears and the rain will stop. And kao is your face. And then O is a direct object marker. And then we have this ageru, which is the imperative brusque command form of ageru, which is to raise or to elevate. And that is an ichiran ru ending verb, so that u ru becomes o ro. So ageru becomes our ageru. So that's like commanding something to raise your face. Don't be sad, because someday your tears will be gone. So pick up your face and let's go. So this ikari here means an anchor. And oh, this is the same exact grammar form here. We just have ikari instead of kao. So instead of raising your face, you're raising the anchor. So the ikari anchor, o makes that the direct object. And then this agero is the same one from here. So that do changes to do for its command form. So raise up your anchor, raise up your face, because let's go. But why we are raising the anchor and where we're going to go with this, we'll have to find out in the next video. If you want to see part two, please subscribe, and I will see you next time. Mata ne!